Okay, this is just a quick video update. Let's start with the scope. I've already applied the satin paint on top of the hammered paint to give you this, as you can see, sort of a textured finish. Okay. I think I did two coats of the hammered paint, so it was applied fairly thick, and then satin paint on top of that. It's something that I had overlooked, actually. I was supposed to spray this with bronze for brass or bronze paint first before the hammered paint. I had bought it too, and I completely forgot about that. So, only way I could to remedy that is just to actually just when weathering this is to paint the I bought some bronze paint or brass paint, and I'm just gonna brush it on, make a weathering effect in and around this this scope here. So. Yeah, what can I say? Well, it is what it is. And as mentioned before, this brass part here are gonna be painted flat black. What else? All right, just quickly here. Added back the screw and this part here. I weathered it using by soaking it in aluminum black. Okay. This one too. I may redo it. I'm not entirely. Oh, we'll see. But I do like the weathered part along the little circles there. It's so those. But we'll see how that goes. Anyway. Yeah, it looks good, especially the bottom part. I like that a lot, how it turned out. Okay, next one is, let's go here. It's the grip. I'm sure the paint's coming off this thing already. That's okay. Again, part of the weathered look of this thingy. Painted the side, so both sides, flat black. Weathered this. I painted this too, but I took off some paint in order to give that weathered look. Trigger. I didn't weather it as much because I figured that in time, because I'm gonna be, handling it over a number over time, so. I'm gonna have that natural weathering when I, pull the trigger. I might even still blue this one too. I believe this is steel, so I'm gonna blue this part and then and this part as well. So that shouldn't take too long. Next up, okay, and finally is this one here, the Hengster counter. I already drilled this part, so it'll see this one. Yeah, it'll go this way. Scope rail. Use a self-tapping screw. I watched Chris's video. it tapped and screwed it, but I just chose to do self-tapping, less work, easier, faster. And thank God I found a screw. My dad's box of hardware he had kept around for years. I believe it was the it's the only one that was there. It was prop it's not focusing. I'm trying to back it up a bit. So it worked out perfectly. I blued it. This is steel, so I blued it with Perma Blue. So you have that color there. So that's pretty much it. Oh, one more thing too. In the interest of a bit of accuracy, I also added this screw here. I noticed in the real Hexler, they had this screw here, and they also had one in the bottom, but I'm not even gonna bother doing that. But I did add the screw here. So next thing up for this is I'm gonna spray this flat black. So yeah. So yep, that's it. That is update. And the major things that still have to be done. Well, that is painting the stock and the main bar the main this one here. Again, I'm waiting for the weather to be much warmer. Because I need, it's gonna take a lot of paint, and it's much better to do outdoors. So, yeah. So other than that, that's pretty much it. Yeah, that's the update. Thanks for watching.